And the flags and all that stuff?
Not the flags, no.
So every flag, all the flags around, I think there's like 37 or something. They represent a different GA swimmer who swam internationally and represented their country. So like last year I went to Rome in Italy. There's an Italian flag here. There was already one here. It could represent a swimmer who came and trained with us. We had a Brazilian kids who came to school here. So there's a Brazilian flag and that was put in place for them. So everything represents something. So it might look like there's just stuff everywhere, but it represents one of his athletes from the 70s, 80s, 90s, and this year, these years. So it's pretty special. And there's, you know, we only have six lanes, 25 yards, and he's had all these great champions. So he has the Basses, he calls the lane seven. He has all, if you look around, there's not an inch of space that's not used because we don't have that much pool space, so we have to put put athletes somewhere. So it's a pretty neat place. I think I've been to a lot of pools, but I've never been to one like this. I know it's a biased opinion because this is where I grew up and my sisters grew up, but it is special and there's a lot of history here. I think you can feel it when you go in the office and see all the pictures on the wall and the things like that. So I think there's a reason why Schoberg has continued to have success. You know, there's some coaches who had a lot of success in the 70s, some in the 80s, some in the 90s, but Schoberg's had success for 40 years, and I think it's because of this type of place. You know, we won a 50 meter pool here, but in the same sense, it'd be sad because this is so steeped in tradition and so special to everyone who ever swam here. So it's a pretty cool place.
Now get back to work.